all about squish bands. The dual purpose of a squish band is to reduce the piston temperature by protecting the edges of the piston from the main combustion area and to increase engine power. If this outer circle is the bore of the cylinder and this inner circle is the edge of the squish band, and in this case 30% of that area is occupied by the squish band, then that gives it a 0.3 squish ratio, or 30%. That ratio increases for low RPM engines. The reason being is that this area right here burns later than this area right here. And so it extends the it extends the pressure. Usually it's all burnt by 30 degrees. It reduces the peak pressure and makes the rest of it fatter or with more PSI and longer. It would take like in this case, it takes all the way to 180 degrees exhaust duration to come down to 10%, whereas with the high peak graph, it's down to 10% at 200 degrees duration. So the idea is to manipulate that squish band for this length of pressure to fit into that time zone between TDC and exhaust opening. This is the crank force derived from these pressures. The crank force is dependent upon the angle between the conrod and the fulcrum of the crank wheel. So as you get lower, as you get closer to 90 degrees, you get a better angle. So even though you have a steep decline in pressure out here, that decline is not the same decline with the crank force graph. And you see that the peak of the crank force is not equal to the peak of the combustion pressure. Your squish velocity, which peaks at 10 degrees before top dead center, controls the rate of increase right here. So with a high RPM engine, you want that rate of increase to be faster because the time between, let's say, 10 degrees before top dead center and 15 degrees after is less. So, a high RPM engine, you want a higher squish velocity than a low RPM engine. So you have those two things going on. You got the squish velocity controlling this part of the graph, and you've got the band width controlling this part of the graph. If this line out here is zero, and this is positive area, this graph out here shows the combustion area. It's not zero at TDC because of the dome volume and the squish volume. So you can see how that graph's out there. The pressure on the piston is a combination of the PSI in the combustion chamber, the conrod angle, and the area of the combustion. So it's those three things. These two graphs, data derived as well as a bit modified to fit the theory. So you can see with more exhaust duration, you need less squish area. Because like I said, you want the combustion to complete faster because you have less time. And also with the exhaust duration increase, you want a decrease in squish volume, or which is actually, in this case, 5 degrees after top dead center. But anywhere you measure it, top dead center, 10 degrees after, 15 degrees after, you'll see this decline. This is my squish calculator. It's an Excel program, and it's got the same graphs that I just showed you, including this one, which is the peak, a generalized idea of what you want as a maximum squish velocity according to the RPM of peak power. So, yeah, it's an Excel program, and the cells for entering information are all in light blue. This is the main data right here. This is the clearance data, the inner diameter of the dome. And if you're not sure of the height above the exhaust port, and you know the exhaust duration, you can put the piston stroke, multiply that by 2 if you don't know the conrod length, put that here, and then look at the duration over here and find the millimeters above exhaust port here to enter right here. So in this case, we've got slightly low squish volume, not horribly low, it's still close enough, yeah, 5%. It's close enough. Squish velocity, really high. Squish ratio, high. So, in this case, the program's telling you, according to the exhaust duration, that the squish ratio should be around 43%, and according to the clearances, according to the dome diameter, the squish ratio is 56%. And right here is the volume at 5 degrees after top dead center, which is very close to what's recommended right here. And you see the peak velocity right here, which exceeds the maximum velocity allowed. So you get these warnings right here. Velocity is too high, increased clearance. Also, the hot velocity is too high. The red graph here is the hot velocity, because it has a rod stretch anywhere from like 0.25 to 0.4 millimeters. So, I'm going to correct this right here by changing the clearance. I'm going to increase the clearance and increase the dome. Which you can increase the dome just by using a rotary tool and grinding away the metal there. To narrow the dome, that's a whole nother subject. There are people that know how to work with aluminum that can do that. And I had that done to one of my heads. And yeah, it's possible. I just don't. That's a good suggestion. So now we've still got good squish volume. And we've got less squish velocity and less squish ratio than is ideal. But I'm not worried about the squish velocity being low. This is what I worry about for power. Of course, getting both of these really close to zero on this graph is ideal. But this affects the pressure graph more than this does. So if you had to choose between the two, I would choose getting this one right. That's the cool thing about this calculator. You can change the clearances, watch what happens to the squish velocity. Look at this graph here, make some changes, etc. There's also a box here that's going to show a detonation risk according to the fuel octane, compression ratio, and clearance and squish velocity. I have many more videos on two-stroke subjects. If you click on the link in the description box, you can go to that page. And if you're really shy about using an Excel program, you can email me all the information, and for a small fee, I can tell you what it's doing and give you a suggestion on how to change it for the better. Okay, so thanks for watching.